do you do a general management plan for 20 to 30 years when you don't know what the island is going to look like in 30 years? And you don't know if the whole reason you became a national park is even going to exist.
What are we going to prioritize? What are we going to protect? What can we protect in the face of rising sea level? It poses a really strong challenge.
We could not stay with what we had always done because we knew it wasn't going to work. The southern end of Assateague Island National Seashore. What you're looking at is the remnants of our parking lot after Hurricane Sandy hit.
Hurricane Sandy created quite a big storm surge here on Assateague.
It was a multi-day event for us because as it passed by, the wind shifted out to the northwest, and then we were bombarded by those winds for about 3 days.
Extremely high bay tides pulled up a lot of this infrastructure like you see behind us, but really flooded our marshes. Obviously it's a salt marsh, so they can tolerate certain pulses of salt water, but you'll notice a lot of damage on the vegetation. A lot of the pine trees that normally don't get saturated with salt water, they're showing signs of stress right now at the spring time of year, and a lot of that is because of Hurricane Sandy and that tidal surge.
So I've been here for 4 years. This is the third time that we've put this parking lot back due to hurricane or storm damage. In our general management plan, we really have tried to figure out how is it that we can really adapt the island. We were one of the first parks that went through scenario planning. And really we looked at sea level rise and storm intensities with those. And so that was another pivotal moment, I would say, in the general management plan that made us realize just how vulnerable this island is. We have been working many years trying to find a way where we could maintain visitor facilities. I think we were trying to keep pace with Mother Nature and to do battle. And we realized that that was just not a good use of the taxpayers' money. When you're on a barrier island, you can fortify in place, which becomes very costly and a lot of times doesn't work, or you can retreat. Or you can become an infrastructure that's very mobile and can be removed at any time. Those are really the three options that you have. And in our general management plan, we're really looking at retreat and then also developing our infrastructure to be sustainable, that they can survive major storms and that they're also movable. And so when there's a storm event, we take every piece of infrastructure that we have on this beach and we take it off of the island. And then come summer, we put it back out there. So it's really been our living laboratory trying to figure out how is it that with the increased likelihood of hurricanes and storm intensity, can we still maintain an infrastructure down here for visitor services? And it's been a lot of experimenting, but we've actually now got it to where a system that works very well for us.
It's all about creating a sense of hope that each one of us in the park, at home, in our jobs, can start to make a difference. We should have evidence that we are trying to respond to climate change, that we're trying to do things differently and better, but also providing an experience that is inspirational and that makes them want to come back again. I'm constantly hearing how much people care about this place, and that makes it a lot easier for me to do my job.
My message for other managers is don't be hooked on what you've done in the past. Really look to the future. The resource that you have is going to change. You need to be able to give it a fighting chance and figure out a way to make that work, to make the park still viable with those impacts that may be taking place.